Hello everyone, my name is João Bernabé,
And my name is Maria Farina.
and this is our work. It's a PowerPoint about the blood-brain barrier in a cellular view. We hope you enjoy it. To start, we'll begin to talk about what is blood-brain barrier and its physiology in a general form. Then we'll focus on the tight junctions and their importance for the BBB, and within the proteins that we are related with the tight junctions, we choose to focus on the claudins, most precisely the claudin 5, that it showed to be more impacting for the physiology of the BBB. And finally, we'll discuss some articles related with this theme.
The blood-brain barrier is an ugly selective layer of endothelial cells which separates central nervous system from the rest of the body. Blood-brain barrier works as a barrier from pathogens and solutes from the blood, as the brain doesn't have immune defenses as strong as the rest of the organism. The endothelial cells that form the barrier are tightly connected one to another, thanks to the tight junctions, in order to minimize as much as possible the paracellular transport. The flux is ideally controlled because even when solutes pass, because tight junctions are a little damaged, specific pumps repump the solutes back to the blood vessels. This is the reason why it's so difficult to cure brain disease. The drug often isn't able to pass the blood-brain barrier.
Here we have the neurovascular unit. The neurovascular unit comprises vascular cells, including endothelial cells and neural cells, such as parasites on brain capillaries, venules, and precapillary arterioles, vascular smooth muscle cells on arterioles, small arteries and veins, glial cells such as astrocytes, microglia, and oligodendrocytes and neurons. And we also have the molecular expression patterns in endothelial and neural cells vary at different levels of vascular tree, creating arteriolar capillary venous heterogeneity.
In this picture are shown different cell types of the neurovascular unit, including vascular cells, glia, and neurons that contribute in processes such as regulation of the blood-brain barrier permeability, cell matrix interaction, neurotransmitter turnover, and angiogenesis and neurogenesis.
So, in these slides, we bring to you a brief resume of the main steps of the development of the BBB. So, early in the development, endothelial cells invaded the narrow epithelium, as you can see here in this figure, figure A. The second step is the angiogenesis occur, invading BECCS, releasing this factor that recruits is used to recruit parasites, that is, these green cells, as you can see here. Then, astrocytes and FEET are recruited to brain vessels and secrete multiple factors as the sonic hedgehog, as you can check here in this figure. And there is a recruitment of these astrocytes, and all these main compounds are used.
The transfer mechanism which molecules use to cross the blood-brain barrier are synthesized in this picture. The diffusion is the most simple way. Small lipophilic molecules follow their concentration gradient so they can diffuse passively through the blood-brain barrier. The paracellular diffusional pathways is possible because disruption and inflammation of the central nervous system lead to weakening of the tight junction, so polar solutes can entry. Carrier-mediated transport is an highly controlled and specific mechanism by carrier proteins with the aim of transferring ions, amino acid, and glucose from blood vessels to brain extracellular space. Receptor-mediated transcytosis is a system that transfers big or hydrophilic molecules such as hormones and proteins thanks to specific receptors that form a vesicle which is released in the brain extracellular space. Absorbed transcytosis has the aim to carry charged molecules. It's similar to the Luther system, but is not specific. Some drugs, even though they are small and lipophilic, are not able to arrive to the brain extracellular space because there are active effluent pumps that recognize the foreign molecules and pump them back to the blood vessel.
Efflux transporters of ATP binding cassette ABC gene are increasingly recognized as important determinants of drug distribution to and elimination from the central nervous system. So, efflux pumps can move a variety of different toxic compounds out of cells, such as antibiotics, heavy metal, organic pollutants, plant-produced compounds, current-sensing signals, bacterial metabolites, and even neurotransmitters. This is a via active efflux. So these proteins, these pumps, uses ATP, uses energy to remove these compounds. Instead of going in for pressing the membrane, they go out. And this is a reason why we have several drugs that cannot reach the brain, is because of this type of pumps that uses energy to remove them, to don't let them in.
Junctional molecules maintain the endothelial-like structural lining. Adherence junctions are situated close to the basolateral membrane and consist of vascular endothelial cadherin and platelet endothelial cell adhesion molecule 1. Then we can see gap junctions such as connexin 30 and 43 forming hemichannels between endothelial cells. Also, the other contribute to the tight lining, including endothelial cell adhesion molecules and junctional adhesion molecule A, B, and C. Tight junctions are situated closest to the apical membrane and consist of lipolysis-simulated lipoproteins such as Claudin-5, on which we will mainly focus in this presentation. This one, with oncodeins and LSR, limit the paracellular diffusion of solutes and ions across the endothelial monolayer. Zonula occludens 1, 2, and 3 bind occludin and claudin to the cytoskeleton, stabilizing the cellular structure. Transwell systems are in vitro systems used to simulate biological barriers and test drugs passage. They are multi-well plates, and in every well there is a basket which never touches the bottom of the plates, but is suspended, and in the well there is a filter where are inserted the cells. So, there are two compartments that communicate only through endothelial cells. Then, fluorescent antibodies are used to verify that the junctions are correctly formed. And then, a molecule is introduced in the apical part and it is possible to study its ability to arrive in the basal part in time. Claudins represent an extended family of transmembrane proteins with 23 family members in humans. Their isoform expression depends on the tissue and developmental stage. In the cells, they are situated close to the apical membrane, where they work within occludins, usually to form a monolayer of cells that divide two compartments. Claudin 5 is the most abundant at the blood-brain barrier, as its expression level is hundreds of times higher than other claudins confirmed in the brain, including claudin 1, 2,
Claudins are selectively expressed in the epithelia. So, in the figure A, at the cerebral blood vessel, stack junction strands at green are arranged at the overlapping parts of neighboring endothelial cells. In the figure B, at the choroid plexus, stack junction strands are arranged at apical parts of the epithel cells. The BBB represented by the red box is characterized by the claudin 5, a phosphoprotein with four transmembrane domains, and it's linked via the scaffolding protein to ZO1 to the proteins of the cytoskeleton such as actin. In the figure E, the BCSFB represented by the green box is characterized by the claudin 3, which acts as a silanant, as does the claudin 5. Orclaudin, a tetraspan transmembrane protein with two large extracellular loops, is obligatory member of tight junction strands, as presented by the black box. Finally, in the figure G, claudin 2, a member of tight junction in the BCSFB, is a paracellular water and cation channel.
Immuno is the chemical stainings of horizontal cross-section of a farming brain shows that claudin 5 is selectively present in the endothelium of brain vessels, whether claudin 1, 2, and 3 are mostly present in the epithelium of the choroid plexus.
Claudin 5 has been reported to play a pivotal role in the BBB integrity and permeability, and as you can see, claudin 5 is observed to be a key component of the tight junction strand, particularly in brain endothelial cells. The major role of claudin 5 is to selectively decrease the permeability to ions. Claudin 5 consists of four transmembrane domains, a short amine group, terminus, two extracellular loops, a short intracellular loop and a longer carboxyl terminus, and also contains a disulfide bond and ion binding site, as well as ion conserved signature motif. The long carboxyl terminus contains the PDZ binding motif for interaction with scaffolding proteins, including ZO1 and 2 and 3. And additionally, the carboxyl acid group terminus contains trafficking and phosphorylation residues. In strokes, we can have two types of strokes: hemorrhagic stroke and ischemic stroke. So, ischemic stroke occurs when blood flows to the brain and it's blocked by a blood clot. And there are two types of ischemic stroke: thrombotic stroke, that are caused when a blood clot forms in an artery leading to the brain, and embolic stroke, that begin with the clot forming elsewhere in the body. These type of strokes, ischemic stroke, are 87% of the cases. But hemorrhagic stroke happens when a weak blood vessel bursts and bleeds into the brain. And we have also two types of hemorrhagic strokes: intracerebral hemorrhage, a weak blood vessel breaking inside the brain, and a subarachnoid hemorrhage, that occurs when a weak blood vessel breaking on the surface of the brain, inside and outside. It's the difference.
The ischemic stroke increases the blood-brain barrier permeability with a biphasic opening that leads to a brain accumulation of peripheral leukocyte and toxic proteins. First, pro-inflammatory cytokines evoke MMP2, which regulates the initial opening. The activation of MMP2 contributes to the degradation of claudin 5, while reactive oxygen species generation are increased. The later opening is mediated by the induction of MMP3 and MMP9 through the nuclear factor Kb activator protein 1 signaling pathway. Proinflammatory cytokine activates COX2 and further regulates claudin 5 expression.
Here we have the claudin 5 redistribution in ischemic condition. During ischemic condition, CAV1 is synthesized in the rough endoplasmatic reticulum as an integral membrane protein. Then they traffic to the Golgi complex to the cell surface. Calvell mediates internalization and recycling of the claudin 5. CCL2 produced during ischemia active CAV1 and claudin 5 translocation from the cytoskeleton to the cytosol, further increasing the BBB permeability.
Claudin 5 has many regulators in the protein expression. For example, several phosphorylation sites have been identified of claudin 5 protein sequence. Phosphorylation and ubiquitination cause a decrease of expression and an increase of degradation.
So now we bring to you a discussion about the claudin 5, and we'll start to Chris Green. So the importance of claudin 5 is that this protein is highly Erickson tight junction protein, as you know, and it's vital to the physical barrier. So there is various upstream signal components that can regulate claudin 5 levels, and manipulating these pathways to modulate claudin 5 expression in response to disease is a viable therapeutic strategy. In addition, RNA interference mediated suppression of claudin 5 is as well characterized, and this strategy to temporarily modulate the BBB permeability to low molecular weight therapies in preclinical model of diseases. Also, downregulation of claudin 5 is narrowly and prominent factor of the multiple sclerosis and epilepsy. In addition, there is a lack of crystal structure of the claudin 5 and how exactly it interacts to form the tight junction strands. In the paper of the Wang, intracranial metastasis tumor have an higher incidence compared with the primary intracranial tumors. The claudin 5 has a distinct and important transmembrane protein of the BBB, as you know already, and it confirmed to be involved in the process of tumor. Here we have a concordance between the articles. Two issues remain to be resolved: how the primary tumor cells affect the fetal claudin 5, and which mechanism the claudin 5 regulates the moiety. Another concordance between these two articles is that there is a little currently known of the regulation and the structure of this protein.
The following resumed article has elaborated the emerging role of claudin 5 in ischemic stroke. In the article resumed on the left has been stated the various upstream signaling pathways can regulate claudin 5 expression and activation at both the transcriptional and non-transcriptional levels. Claudin 5 is involved in blood-brain barrier dysfunction, and in a stroke is associated with neurospecific drivers of pathogenesis, including inflammatory disequilibrium and oxidative stress. Most of the tight junctions disappear after a stroke, but only claudin 5 reappears in newly formed BECs. Claudin 5 might be a potential marker to detect early hemorrhagic transformation in ischemic stroke. Evidence suggests that claudin 5 has also a neuroprotective role in regulation of blood-brain barrier in ischemic strokes. However, more preclinical studies are required, but claudin 5 can be considered a valuable therapeutic target for ischemic stroke. Furthermore, the research group of Aixia Liao demonstrated that permeability of blood-brain barrier in ischemic brain tissue stroke is significantly increased. With claudin 5, also occludin and ZO1 tight junction-associated proteins, which have a different structure, are all important in maintenance and function of the tight junctions. After a cerebral ischemia, the significant reduction of claudin 5 is one of the causes of the blood-brain barrier leakage. These findings suggest that the decrease of the expression of spike junction might contribute to the blood-brain barrier disruption depending on the time during an ischemic stroke. In this presentation, we demonstrated how is important the presence of a protein like claudin 5 that could be apparently insignificant, and furthermore investigation would help to find therapies to prevent damages like by ischemic stroke and by paracellular passage from blood vessels to nervous central system of pathogens and toxic molecules. Thank you for watching.
If you want, you can check the articles. You have here the information that you need. We prepared for you a little quiz and we are really looking forward to see your questions. So enjoy it and be happy.